Hey, check it. It's vlog at a 680.
Morning, it's Sunday, which means today is, Mercy Ships Monday. Somebody was not paying attention to his calendar this morning. It also means it's time for yoga. I'm gonna go do yoga with Natasha. I don't know if I should wear my watch or not. And then I'm gonna go, I think I wanna go by the Bastille Market because I haven't been to the market for a little bit and that'd be fun. And then I think I'm gonna go pick up a printer from Kylie. Mathieu, thank you for offering me your printer. Sorry it took me so long. But then Kylie's leaving and has to get rid of it. And so I figured yours can go to a good cause down the line. Hers has to go to a good cause soon. I'm a half decent cause. I'll take it. It's really bright out. The sun is just pounding straight into the room this morning. Oof. I slept great. I'm just a little sleepy. And we're gonna undo that or make it worse with yoga. I don't even know how this really works. I'm still not much of a yogi, but you know, I'm sure I'll feel much better. Let's get the day started. Exercise is pretty hard to come by on the ship. There were some really good opportunities. There's actually a guy who ran an exercise class in the mornings that was supposed to be really great, and I don't think I ever really went. And this is before I was really getting into fitness. You have to remember, if we were talking yesterday, I was not quite at the point in my weight loss journey when I was actually like intense into working out. It was also early in the morning. I had a job I really didn't like when I was first on the ship and was just kind of stressed out and miserable. And I should have been exercising because it would have made everything better, but I didn't. So that's one little regret. There's also a gym on the ship, like a small gym with some stationary bikes, some weights. Another thing that I didn't really take full advantage of. I used it every once in a while, but never with much discipline. The only way that I ever really got much exercise on the ship was running and occasionally golf. But golf's not much for exercise. It is, you know, leisurely. It's pleasurable. But we might have to save the golf stories for another time. Oh, that's a juicy peach. I just need some food before yoga. I'm on the hunt for a bakery. I'm walking away from the yoga place in search of food. I did find a really interesting cafe that serves chimney cakes. They sound amazing. We'll have to go check that out later. I really want to try it. Oh, there's a bakery. He's hoping the line moves quickly. I know how much you miss panna chocolate, Jeff, so, you know, you can think of this as being for you if you want.
But really, for me, I'm hungry.
After the insistence of many, including Natasha, I'm doing yoga today before coffee. It's interesting, I drink coffee now, I'm a coffee drinker. It's a problem. I mean, I love it, it's really good, but I'm looking forward to my coffee after this. I feel fine. I just feel kind of sleepy a little bit. So hopefully the yoga is relaxing, rejuvenating, and you know, then we'll go get coffee immediately after. It was really good.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Lost in the traffic.
That was amazing. It was really good. I feel like I'm floating right now a little bit. We're gonna do market lunch, and then hopefully coffee, and I'll figure myself out from there. It was really good though. I wake up naturally this way. Oh, that's way too hot. There's no way I'm drinking this yet. That was about to be dangerous. They had no seating inside, so we're having neighbor's coffee next door. Ironic, isn't it? Yeah, you like it? Didn't have any Crocs, which is what I'm after, because the Patreon food poll this week demands that I eat a Croc Madame. That's what we're on the mission for. She wants salad. I need a Croc. We failed. So, attempt number two is underway. We'll talk about running in Mercy Ships here in a minute, because that's basically all the exercise I really ever did was mostly running and a little bit of like cross training on deck. I wanted to go in Victor Hugo's house, and apparently we're doing that at, before lunch now. Fine by me. If you want to know, just let me know. Stop by Victor Hugo's house on the bike tour, and it's free to go in, but I've never been in here. So they actually have an exhibition as well, so it's not just Victor Hugo's apartment. That part's not free. I think it's only like €8 or something, but we just want to go do the free part. That was fun. It's nice. It's a very quick tour. Simple. Just walk through, see his deathbed, and then, you know, lunch. Are you hungry?
Yes.
Yeah, you're really hungry. Let's go eat. Normally, you don't have to assemble your own croque madame. Not sure what happened there. Anyways, patrons, there you go. We'll get back to the exercise thing eventually. But in the meantime, I need to clog my arteries. The difference between a croque monsieur and a croque madame is the egg, which is why I said assemble your own. But a croque monsieur is basically sometimes an open-faced sandwich. Sometimes, in this case, it's a sandwichy sandwich, and you end up with like ham and cheese, and the cheese is melted on top. Buttery, very tasty. There's some cream involved sometimes. And I don't know what all else goes into it besides that and maybe a little bit of magic. Am I missing I feel like it's just ham and... It's basically a ham and cheese sandwich with cheese melted on top, a little bit lightly toasted. And in the case of a croque madame, an egg on top, like a fried egg. I hope this is satisfying to those of you who voted for this. And thanks for not making me eat tartare. I did need to eat steak tartare at some point, but I wasn't ready for that. All right, time to go get a printer and a Chemex. Then I can feed my addiction on my own terms. Kylie also has one of the more killer views of the city from here. Look at this. Printer. Wish I had this when I had to do all that paperwork for the prefecture. That would have been extremely handy. She's gonna bring the Chemex by later. She's gotta clean, getting out of the apartment. It's all over. She'll be gone in a couple days. And then I gotta go get an oven from Renna. This is like hand-me-down central right now, but having an oven would be amazing. And she's gonna give me a blender. Like, it's one that'll grind the coffee beans, so I'll have that, but then I can make salsa. Man, we're about to start living large soon. I made it. Speaking of needing exercise, so to conclude, I guess we're bookending with Mercy Ships Monday today. Running was one of the things that I was able to do on the ship pretty much everywhere. The one major downside, well, there were two, depending, because in some of them you could only really run on the dock, and the dock's only, you know, what, 400, maybe 500 feet of space to run in, probably not that much. So there's a lot of running back and forth on just flat terrain, really boring. The other downside is even if you could run out through the port, you had a lot of dust and exhaust and just smoke and all kinds of stinky stuff that you're running through. And so you ended up like kind of coughing halfway through your run. I mean, it wasn't so bad. I mean, we weren't like dying or anything, but I just remember in Freetown running with my buddy Jeff. You haven't met this Jeff yet, but my buddy Jeff Locke. We would go running out into Freetown. It's just an obstacle course, basically, the whole time. Plus the like really ridiculously bad air quality and just running through it. And I just remember actually really liking it. And I wish that I would have been in better shape to fully enjoy it, because I really wasn't in running shape back then and didn't get into running until later. Weight loss journey, yesterday's video. But
I really did. I don't know. It was always a really interesting run, especially when you're going with friends. And it was a great way to see more of the port than you normally saw, because usually when you're jumping in a Land Rover or walking out of the port, there's only one path you would take, and we would actually run like the length of the port and leave out one of the other gates. And so we'd actually get to see a lot more of the port. We get to see different parts of the city that we normally wouldn't. And I really highly recommend, if you want to explore a place, if you want to come to Paris and explore, or anywhere in the world, going for a run to explore is a really good way to do it. That's actually how I found a couple of coffee shops around here that I really like. And I really need to be running in town more just to explore. Just gotta do it in the morning. You don't wanna run in the afternoon in Paris. It gets kind of crazy, especially in certain parts of the city, like where it's kind of touristy. You do not wanna run like after 10:30 in the morning. It's just done. Absolutely done. Anyways, that was like a loosely disjointed Mercy Ships Monday for you. I hope you enjoyed it. I'm gonna go ahead and try to cool down a little bit and get to work. I haven't gotten the work I need to get done yet today. And I also wanna make sure that I edit my vlog and whatnot, get some sleep. So I will see you bright and early tomorrow morning for another wonderful Monday morning. I'll be teaching English this week. We'll see how things turn out. And then we're traveling to the coast, and that will be amazing. Talk to you tomorrow morning.